you know, just looking in the Alameda County area, you're now literally looking at the data, same exact statistics that I've been talking about from the beginning, average outcomes in adulthood for kids growing up in low-income families, census tract by census tract across the county, right? So the first thing I want you to notice is that the spectrum of colors you're seeing on your screen here is the same as what you saw in the national map. So you can go from the darkest reds in parts of Oakland here to the deepest blues if you look at other parts of Oakland, just going a few miles down the street, right? So what is that telling you? You can basically go from Alabama to Iowa in terms of rates of upward mobility just by driving down the road in Oakland or, you know, in Alameda County more generally. And Oakland is not unique in that respect. You see that pattern basically in every city in America. So what is that telling us? It's telling us that the roots of economic opportunity, the where these disparities are arising, it's not coming from state level factors or broad regional factors, you know, state level policies and things like that. Just a few city blocks, you know, kids who grow up in across one side of the street relative to another side of the street, we find in many instances have very different life trajectory. These are systematic patterns based on thousands of data points in all of these different places. So there's really something systematically different going on in these different neighborhoods. So what that shows you is we need to be thinking at a very local level about how to improve economic opportunity. So what do you learn from this chart? I think there are three key takeaways. The first is that where you grow up really seems to matter. And if we change children's environments, we can have dramatic impacts on their lifetime success, right? And so that's incredibly encouraging because challenging problems like a persistent lack of opportunity, you might worry like, do I have to look at a different country or go back to the 1950s in America to figure out how we get back to high levels of upward mobility? And what these data are showing you is no, you just have to look like a couple miles down the street. And turns out if a child was to grow up in that environment instead of where they are now, they could have a very different life trajectory. That shows this is eminently changeable. The second thing that, that you learned from this analysis is that what really matters is childhood environment rather than where you live as an adult, right? You can see that in this study and various other studies we've done. The third thing you see is that every extra year of exposure to a better childhood environment improves kids' long-term outcomes. But at the end of the day, we want to make it less important, basically, which neighborhood you live in for as a determinant of your kids' outcomes. We want to bring opportunity to every neighborhood.